In this game, we have the Bears and we have the Saints, right? Right now, the spread is at minus 10 points for the Saints, and the over-under is at 47 points. I'm going to recommend the Bears plus 10 points. That's what I'm going to recommend. Now, if I felt the Saints were 100%, right, I would totally take the Saints. I feel the Saints are a superior team to the Bears, right? They're just a really good team. At one point in the season, they had 9 wins in a row. There was a period there where over the course of 5 games, their defense held those teams to a total of 44 points. Like, they had some serious runs. They blew out the Bucks. Like, the Saints were on a huge roll. And then Drew Brees got injured, and then it just a few things snowballed. And, you know, they had 2 losses. You know, one was to the Chiefs, and then they kind of rebounded against the Vikings, although I don't know if that's a rebound because the Vikings, I mean, when did you see the Saints defense give up 30 points to a Vikings team, right? Like, it just, the Saints don't strike me as 100% healthy right now. I think if they were 100% healthy, the Vikings would not have put up 30 points against them. They're just too good of a team. And when I look at the Saints right now, I see Drew Brees. He may have recovered from his rib injury, but he's still not in 100% form from it. He's missed a lot of football. You know, I see Alvin Kamara. Like I said, he has 21 touchdowns under his belt. Alvin Kamara, rushing and receiving, and he has over 1,700 yards rushing and receiving, and he's Drew Brees' favorite target when Drew Brees is in. He's been out because of COVID, right? And he's been practicing through, you know, whatever system they're using online. He hasn't actually been able to physically practice with his team. So, and then I see Michael Thomas. He's been dealing with injuries. Trey Hendrickson's dealing with an injury. These are big players. Like, Alvin Kamara is a huge part of the Saints team. Trey Hendrickson is a huge part of their defense. Like, you know, he's one of the top in the top 10 in QB sacks in the NFL. Like, these are big time names, right? Drew Brees, Alvin Kamara, Trey Hendrickson, right? Michael Thomas. So when I look at the Saints right now, I see a team that's not firing on all cylinders, right? And they haven't even been able to practice at 100% because of COVID protocols. So I feel like the Bears may have got a little bit of a lucky break. Now, be careful. I'm not saying the Bears are going to win. Don't misunderstand me. And I may not be the best person for this recommendation because I'm a little salty with the Saints, right? The last 3 years in a row, I feel like this team has burnt me, right? They including this year, they've won their division 4 times now. And they've had a really good team the last, you know, couple years. And they lost to Casey Keenum and the Vikings. They lost to, who's the other guy? Casey Keenum. And then they lost to Kirk Cousins and the Vikings. And then they lost to Jared Goff and the Rams. Games and quarterbacks they should not have lost to. Drew Brees is too good. The Saints were too good, you know, and I picked them in those games and they lost, right? Huge upsets. Those were all upsets. It should not have happened. If the Saints somehow lose this game to Mitchell, Trubisky, and the Bears, and Drew Brees decides to retire, and this is how he retires, his last 4 years losing to Casey Keenum, Kirk Cousins, Jared Goff, and then Mitchell Trubisky, that will not be good. I refuse to believe this could even happen. I refuse to believe this could even happen. No way. And that's not what I'm saying in this game. That's not why I'm picking the Bears, because I think they're going to pull off an upset. I think they're going to keep the game close, right? The Bears are at the bottom of the pack in blitz percentage. I want to say they're like 27th, 28th. They don't blitz a whole lot. That's not their defensive scheme. They trust in their front four, right? They got Akeem Hicks. They got Quinn. They got Khalil Mack, right? Like, they got an excellent D-line. So when you don't blitz a lot, that means you can fill passing lanes. And Drew Brees, because of his injury, because of, you know, he's at the tail end of his career, he's adjusted his game in short passes. Now, it's not a knock against him. I'm not trying to take a shot at him. He's 2nd in the NFL in completion percentage. It works. Like, it works. But it chews up clock, right? And if you can play the passing lanes, it'll be successful. But I see, in other words, I see a game where there's a lot of time and clock eaten up, right? Because of how the Bears play defense. I'm not saying they're going to prevent the Saints from scoring. I just say it's going to be more controlled. Remember, these two teams played each other already, right? It was a close game. It went into overtime, and the Saints won the game in overtime, right? And this is playoff football. Everybody brings their absolute best, right? And the Bears have, like I said, Khalil Mack. They get the linebacker, Roquan Smith. Like, this is a legit Bears defense. Right now, they're 15th against the run, and they're 12th against the pass. And those numbers should be better. If you remember with the Bears, they started off the season really good, and then they lost six games, right? And a lot of this had to do with a quarterback controversy between Nick Foles, right, and Mitchell Trubisky, and then the head coach, Matt Nagy. You know, they're talking about firing him, and then he transfers the play calling to Bill Lazor. And there was a lot of stuff going on there, and I could see the defense getting down, right? That's just negative energy. Those numbers should be better. And at the beginning of the year, they were much, much better. That Bears defense is starting to play good again. And I get it. They just got beat by the Packers. But if you watch that Packers game, right, there was a really bad fumble that set the Packers up for a touchdown. There was a big interception. And going into the fourth quarter, the Bears were only down by 5 points, right? The Packers scored 14 points in the fourth quarter. That game could have ended much differently with the ball bouncing a few different ways, or if they protect the ball, right? And that's what I see in this game. I see a more controlled play calling, right? Because Mitchell Trubisky over the last five games, not just the three wins, over the last five games, he's averaging a completion percentage of 73.5. And that's all they need from him. They don't need a 400-yard game from him. They just need him to be accurate with the ball. That's it. Just be accurate with the ball and stay within the play calling, because they lean on their defense, right? And then they got the wide receiver, Allen Robinson, and then David Montgomery, their running back, is starting to catch fire. So I see a game here where I see a team that's not 100% in the Saints, right? I don't see Drew Brees at 100%. I don't see Michael Thomas at 100%. Like I said, he hasn't practiced all week, right? He's been questionable all year. Alvin Kamara hasn't practiced, all online, Trey Hendrickson questionable. Like, maybe that's a coach playing games so they can, coaches lie about stuff to try and get the other coach to plan for something they're not even going to do. Like, I could see something like this, but I still feel like the Saints are not 100%. So anyway, this is what I see. I see a tight game, right? And I see the Saints emerging victorious by a touchdown. I don't see a high scoring game either, but I'm scared to take the under because of what I saw these two teams do the first time. I can see the Bears putting up some points, right? Not a ton of points, but I could see the Bears putting up, 21 points. And then I could see the Saints putting up 28 points, something like that. Maybe like 31, 24, 28, 21, something like that. I, in other words, you're getting 10 points. I like the Bears plus 10 points in this game. It's a playoff game. Both sides are going to bring it. And I think the way Bill Lazor calls games, he's going to be very careful with Mitchell Trubisky, especially against this Saints defense, right? They have Marshawn Lattimore, Janoris Jenkins, Malcolm Jenkins. Like, I just see a very controlled, well thought out game. And because of this, I think the Bears will keep it respectable. And Saints fans, your team better not lose this game. No way. Hey, everyone. Thank you for watching SP Sports today. Please don't forget to click the subscribe button down below. This way you are notified when we post new videos. Also, if you have a moment, leave a comment and check out our other videos.